Everybody, welcome to a special live Bedford Day edition of the Bedford TV Sports Report. For those of you who watch every week, which is probably everybody here, we broadcast every Monday night from the Bedford TV studios at 6 o'clock, and sports takes about 5 to 7 minutes. We talk about primarily Bedford sports, high school sports, and youth sports, ranging into Boston and world sports with some humor and trivia always, and generally have a good time. I've been doing it for 3 years. This is our second version of the live Bedford Day Sports Report. Last time we had volleyball players and soccer players and football players. So we're going to start today with volleyball, but before we do that, I do want to introduce the co-host and Bedford resident Kyle Draper, who some of you might know from another television station. I'm not sure which one, so Kyle, welcome.
What do you mean you're not sure which
I'm
one?
I'm not sure which
you
one. I think it might be
every
Nesson
night.
Or Yes Network, or I forget which
Comcast,
one it is.
Comcast, Sportsnet, soon to be NBC Sports Boston. Next our, week, we're
next
changing
week,
our name.
I think
NBC
I saw that.
Sports Boston.
Awesome. So Kyra's a great sports broadcaster and a great Twitter follow if you're looking for more Twitter follows. But enough about us. This isn't about us. It's about the young ladies who we have here from the volleyball team. So if you could just introduce yourselves, say how old you are, and how long you've been playing volleyball, and then we'll take it from there.
Hi, my name is Cameron Racky. I'm a junior, and this is my third year playing volleyball.
Hi, my name's Kate. I'm also a junior, and this is also my third year.
Hi, my name's Natalie Knight. I'm a senior, and I played volleyball since seventh grade around then.
Natalie, are you a captain, or should I not ask that?
I am a captain.
Congratulations.
Yes.
How many captains are there?
There are three, so we got three co-captains this year.
You might call them tri-captains.
We may, yes.
Awesome. So the volleyball team, for those of you that don't know, had a very successful year last year. Co-DCL small champions, but an early playoff exit, if I'm not mistaken. But it was a young team, and there was high hopes for this year. And the year started not in Bedford, but in Florida. So Natalie, maybe talk a little bit about the Florida trip and what that was. Why'd you go, and was it great for the team, or was it just a distraction from preschool activities?
So the whole BHS volleyball program got to take a trip down to Disney. So we played at the ESPN Worldwide Sports Center complex. So we had a lot of practice with some more competitive teams from the South mostly. So it was a good experience to play against those teams for our preseason and get to know our players more as a team in that sense.
And was it a successful foray into this tournament, or was it a short trip, short experience in the tournament?
5 days, but we played almost every day there. Didn't come out with too many wins, but you know, good experience nonetheless, definitely.
So I only have, I mean, I'm not a volleyball expert. I'm aware that height is an advantage, Natalie, when
correct.
You play volleyball. So how does your team rank when it comes to height?
This year, we're on the shorter side, but still fierce. So we got Cameron, who's a pretty effective wall at the net, so, yeah.
A very effective tall person?
Yes.
It's the best kind of tall person in volleyball. And do you play different positions? Do you guys have specializations? How does that work?
Yeah, so we all play different positions. This year, I'm playing libero. Last year, I played outside hitter.
Okay, you wanna... I play outside hitter.
Can you just describe for the audience what that means when you say outside hitter? Because I have no idea what it means.
Okay. So there's six people on the court, and the hitters are usually in the front row. So I play the left front row position.
On the outside.
And sometimes defense as well. I go around. So.
And I'm a middle, meaning I'm in the middle of the court, and I'm an offensive player, so I'm always hitting. And my job as a middle is to block, which stops the balls from getting over the net. So.
Does that usually work because you're tall?
Yes, it actually, I've had a pretty amazing. Good success rate. So
amazing. And the season. So the season started, I think, first week of school. You've had a couple of tough matches against some powerhouses. Lincoln Sudbury, I know, is always very good. That wasn't the best match for you guys. But some wins. So, I mean, how's the team doing? What's the prognosis? And what are your goals for this season, I guess?
Well, we started out with 17 players. Yeah. But then because of injuries or sickness, we're down to nine.
Nine players?
So it's been a little bit rough, but we're starting to get our edge back, and we're starting to get better and better as the days go on.
I assume that's a small roster.
Yeah, it's a little small.
And is there a JV team as well?
Yes, there is a JV team. We've actually had three players move up from JV, and they're practicing with us now. So.
Wow. Do you get a lot of fans? Besides Jeffrey Hoyland, who's at all of your games, taking lots of pictures.
Yeah, he's our number one fan. Yeah, we have a pretty good fan base. We got a lot of people supporting us. Yeah, a lot of parents.
Good parents, excellent. And how long does the season go until late October? Does it go into November? And when does the tournament start?
So regular season goes until the end of October. Then if we make the state's tournament, it could go into November.
And what are the odds, you think, of a repeat DCL small crown? Or is that looking elusive given the injuries and concussions that seem to be?
That might be a hard goal to reach, yep, given the fact that we've just had a rough start with, yep, everything that's going on with our health. So we're fighting. We're getting back on our feet. So we're hoping.
And what does training look like for volleyball? How did you, what was the off season like? Did you have a specific program you had to follow? What do you do in season? Is it just practices? What does the workout of a volleyball player look like?
So off season, a lot of players play club volleyball, which happens like end of fall through winter, beginning of spring. And then I actually did beach tournaments over the summer. So
I think I saw that in the Minuteman. Was that your picture, the 2-on-2 beach stuff? Was that right?
I think that might have been last year, but I did it again this year.
Sure.
So getting some touches in that way. And then I'd say like cardio, running. Kate's a runner.
I run.
Thanks. Yeah. Thanks for chiming in. There was a race in Bedford this morning. Hopefully people saw it. I'm wearing the beautiful maroon race shirt. I was hoping for baby blue, which I told Jen on Monday night. So a lot of cardio. Any like, you know, plyometrics or hopping around or that? Oh, yes.
Yeah, so right. Part of our job is blocking and jumping. So we're always doing that stuff. We're always going hard, doing sprints, because it's more of a fast workout than more slow. So it's always
fast workouts, not slow. Excellent. But you, I assume you stretch. Are you into like the Tom Brady stretching protocol? A lot of like flexibility bands and drinking lots of water,
not
or not
much,
really?
But we do make sure to stretch before and after practice, so that way we don't get injured. So.
All right, Kyle. There we go.
Who would you consider your biggest rivals? And you know, when you talk about football, we hear about Concord Carlisle, that rivalry game. What about for you guys? Is there a rivalry on the volleyball court as well?
Definitely last year it was probably Weston, because they had a killer team and we were actually co-championships with them for the state tournament. This year it might be Concord Carlisle, just because so many of the girls in our program have played club teams with girls from that program too. So we're friends off the court, and before we were friends on the court with them on the same team, but now we're against the net from each other. So
is it, I heard, is it the Gators? Is that what a lot of girls do, the Gators club? Is that, and where is that based out of?
That's a local team. Frank Gardner runs the Gators. That's how I started playing volleyball.
I actually started playing volleyball my freshman year with the high school, and then I was introduced to by a coach who said, try this out because you're progressing really well.
Right.
So I tried it out, and I'm stuck with the Gators team for, I think, 2 years now, and it's been really great.
Where do they practice?
They have practices in the Lane School in Bedford. And
the Joe Blaine School.
Joe Blaine School. Nice. Wonderful.
I'm like, familiar with it.
Skip around the block. It was great because all my teammates come from like a little further away, and I'm here like, oh, it's been a 5-minute ride, I think. But it's been a really great experience there.
And any Gator work for you?
Yeah. I did it my freshman year, and I found it was like really nice. I got to improve my skills, and I came a lot. But I was a lot better when I came back my sophomore year. So,
would you say Bedford has a good volleyball development program, or do girls kind of stumble into it when like, oh, maybe I should try volleyball because my coach from cross country said check it out? Like, how does one discover this vocation, I guess, is the question.
Well, I never played volleyball before going to high school, and I knew it was something I wanted to try out. So I went, I did captain's practice and tryouts, and I just fell in love with the sport. It was so fun, and like the girls on the team are great. So.
And how'd you fall into volleyball?
I started my freshman year as well. I had a bunch of friends who thought it'd be great because there was a unit in PE about it, and we excelled there. So we said, why don't we do it? And that's basically how it got.
For me, I think it was a group of friends. We were like, hey, this is cool. And then Frank also, I kind of went to some clinics with Gators, so that's how my interest peaked, and then I stuck with it. And I think that's how it starts for most freshmen in high school. They're like, this seems like a cool thing to try out, and most of the freshman girls will end up making the freshman team, which is great, so then they can go through all three teams at high school and get some more experience.
So as a parent of a high school freshman, everyone wonders about what's high school like when you're balancing sports and academics and work commitments. How do you balance in-season volleyball workout, homework, all that? Does it fit? Is it a challenge? Does it get easier the older you get? I'm sure it's a different answer for every person, but I'm wondering, how does Bedford balance the athletics and the academics? Because I hear it's actually done pretty well.
I'd say it definitely is a big challenge, and going through high school, it will get easier, so that's something to remember, tell your kids too. Time management is key, procrastination, horrible, but try and minimize that, I'd say. And sports, I found, is kind of like my time to de-stress and practice and everything like that. So I'd say it can be challenging at times, but it's totally worth it to be involved in clubs for the social aspect and everything like that.
There's something about physical exertion that gets you really in the mood for like just sitting down and doing all my homework in one night. I find coming back from practice or a game when I'm really hyped up that I find it's a lot easier to do homework or to be motivated to do homework for some reason.
It's good for your brain.
It's good for your brain, yeah. I find that when I'm in a sport, I want to do work more, and I find time with my teammates to do work together, and I think that's a lot better.
So my last question from this side of the table, which has nothing to do with volleyball, is we live in a great sports town, I think. I grew up in a great sports town. So of your Boston sports teams and athletes, which was your favorite team and which one's your favorite Boston athlete? And we'll start down here.
Well, just naturally, living in New England my entire life, I'm a diehard Patriots fan, Tom Brady all the way. So,
are you going to buy his book?
I don't know.
I'm not going to buy it.
Not going to buy it?
not going to buy it, sorry.
I mean, if he can write a book as well as he can throw a ball, maybe.
I think he's trying to sell us something besides, football wisdom. That's just me. You can't repeat the same answer, so try.
No, I like the Patriots. Okay, I like Pats. I like Edelman, although he's out, so it's a bummer. Good. It's a bummer, but yeah.
Beyond volleyball, I'm not much of a sports person, so I might just have to go with Misty May Trainer.
Oh, good answer.
So, yeah.
Good answer. Did you watch the gold medal match there from the last Olympics and say, oh my gosh, you weren't there? And
I did.
It's okay. Good for them. Quite a run.
Quick story, Dan. I interviewed Misty May Trainer and Kerry Walsh when they were together. They were on the AVP beach circuit, and to this day, I have a signed ball from the both of them. And I follow Kerry Walsh on Instagram and Twitter because I'm a huge fan of hers. So we do have that in common, you know. Would you ladies like to continue your playing career after high school, do you think?
The past few years I've been thinking about that a lot, like whether I wanted to play volleyball seriously in college. But at this point, I think because I love the sport so much, I don't want to give it up. But I'd probably play it as like a club or an intramural level.
Yeah, I agree. My favorite part about the sport is that it's so skill-based that you always see yourself becoming better every year, and I think that would be great to continue that.
Yeah, I love the sport, and I always want to keep playing it, so I'll probably just do a club team in college, especially since it's so competitive to do it in college. It's just a little harder to do it.
Well, what I love about volleyball is watching the games, and after each point, there's the joy of the point that's won and the coming together, or the, like, we got the next one. And there's always a moment to be with your teammates and to celebrate or say it's okay, and I think it's a great team sport. We played great in Bedford. Your girls represent the program really well, so thanks for the time you gave us this morning. Good luck this season. We'll see you in the playoffs. We're not giving up hope. And we'll take a short break and be back with some cross-country runners and a softball player. Have a great Bedford day. Well.